Thousands have poured through Christchurch Museum over the summer, all here to witness street art takeover. The OIU Festival is a new take on graffiti. The museum says the public's reaction has blown them away. More than 2,000 people walk through the doors every day.
We've had such a good lot of feedback from all parts of the community. It's not young people, it's not old people, it's the whole gamut. Internationals, locals, everybody seems to get a chuckle or a laugh or something thoughtful out of it. Because it's not just in your face. There's some quite thoughtful, provocative political commentary. The end strange final act is pretty emotional for Christchurch people.
The painted walls are not only eye-catching. They all have a story or a hidden meaning. The festival is overflowing onto the streets of Christchurch. Dozens of walls around the city are being covered in art.
Christchurch people deserve some fun, some colour, some razzle dazzle, and this is, I think, just the sort of thing to do that.
Yikes is one of the local artists involved in the festival. His mural is one of the first to welcome you as you walk through the doors in the museum. His art is plastering the walls next to some of the best in the world. But before the festival began, he was perfecting his technique on an abandoned site in Lyttelton.
Just trying to kind of brighten the city up for ourselves and for the city itself as well. I mean, there's a lot of walls that have been let go and kind of a bit derelict, you know. So we kind of, it's a good opportunity for people like us to actually make a mark as well and to kind of help the city pick itself back up as well.
What's been filling the streets around Christchurch shouldn't be confused for tagging. There's an extra depth to what's being seen, and it's more than art.
You're often having to find yourself having to explain a lot of it.
Every lie that I ever told, paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold.
This is my world.
Somewhere I heard that life is a test. I've been through the worst, but I still get my best. God made my mold different from the rest. Then he broke that mold, so I know I'm blessed.
This is my world.
Stand up now and face the sun. Hide my tail or turn and run. It's time to do what must be done. Be a king when kingdom comes. Well, you can tell everybody.
A larger-than-life mural of Nelson Mandela adorns the side of the Christchurch YMCA. He's an international freedom fighter. The artist behind it says it symbolises their diverse cultures walking the streets of Christchurch.
He's had a lot to do with where the world's at now. And with his recent passing and everything, I was thinking about a good idea to be able to put on the wall that actually meant something. And he was a symbol that I thought meant a lot to everybody that will come in and out of here.
After a successful season, the festival is wrapping up in March.
It has been incredibly popular. I mean, we knew it would be popular when we decided to take it, but we weren't prepared for the... It's just been over the top in terms of the numbers of people coming through.
But it's not going far, moving just metres down the road.
We're redeveloping a big building that's at the YMCA, and we're turning it into what we believe is the world's first purpose-built street art centre.
The climbing wall's days are numbered. It's going to be turned into something more special.
But also that's going to be the home to the Banksy works and the other works that are part of our collection, and we just want to build on that and turn it into something totally unique, not just in this part of the world, but across the globe.
With Christchurch becoming a permanent home for street art, organisers say the city has the ability to become the new art capital of the world. Emma Cropper, CTV News.